5, 4, command engine start, 2, 1, ignition.
Back in November, I became the 100th woman to fly to space. Going to space has been something that I've dreamed about and worked toward for 2 decades. And I want you to join me as I prepare for and embark on my trip to the stars. 3 days before our launch, we arrive in Texas.
That's one small step for man,
Texas has always played an important role in space exploration, but we're not headed to NASA. We're headed to the middle of the West Texas desert to Blue Origin Launch Site 1, where they launch and land astronauts in a rocket of their own design. Unlike the rockets used by Neil Armstrong, Sally Ride, and Mae Jemison, to name a few, the rocket we'll be flying in is fully autonomous and 99% reusable. This means there are no spacecraft pilots on board, and the entire rocket will be autonomously launched into space 62 miles above the planet and autonomously landed back down on Earth. We're flying in the New Shepard rocket, named after the first American in space, Alan Shepard, who flew a similar flight trajectory as our flight. My launch will be the 28th New Shepard flight overall. That's why we're the NS-28 mission, the 9th human flight for Blue Origin, and finally the 11th launch of this exact rocket. As soon as we arrive in the astronaut village, we meet the crew that we'll be flying with. And then it was time to settle in our individual airstreams to relax and sleep before the start of our busy training schedule.
We each get our own little airstream. This is the bathroom. We have our little living area here, a kitchen. There's Tommy. And then we have our bedroom here. You can see human for size. I've taped some of my family and friends' pictures here. I have the 99 female astronauts who came before me. There is one spot left to fill, which I plan to fill on Friday.
As the host of my show, Exploration Outer Space, I'd actually met and interviewed many of these women. And for the last 10 years of producing my show, I often wondered if I would ever get to see what they saw. In a few days, I'd get my chance.
Good morning from the astronaut village. I'm on my way to the first day of astronaut training.
Good morning, astronauts. Welcome to the Astronaut Training Center.
Woo-hoo! Yay!
The last time I was here, I was interviewing other astronauts. And now, my name is on the door.
It was the most emotional feeling seeing my name stitched into that blue suit, something I dreamt about for a long time. With my suit on and my adrenaline pumping, I headed to the next step of training.
This is a simulator, so this is a mock-up, a one-to-one mock-up of the New Shepard capsule. So we can go in and get a feel for it. We can look out the windows. We can feel all the handholds and sit in the seats and get a feel for what it might be like when we're up in space. Right now, we are getting fitted, custom fitted for our own astronaut seats.
These must fit perfectly because in an emergency scenario, the capsule can be ejected away from the rocket so quickly that your body will experience 15 G-forces, which wouldn't feel great if your seat wasn't perfectly positioned beneath you.
We have a 5-point harness in there, and so we're going to practice getting in and out of that harness because the few minutes of weightlessness that we have in space at Apogee are so precious, and we do not want to be fiddling with our 5-point harness.
As an aerospace engineer with 4 degrees in technology and engineering, it was really important to me to have science be part of my mission.
These are my science seeds!
I'm working with an organization called Fast Plants to fly seeds with me to understand how spaceflight affects plant growth on a microscopic level. In addition to my own experiment, I'll be wearing a bio button.
Now, this will be taking my vitals throughout the duration of training and our spaceflight, and will be part of a cohort of over 20 astronauts, both suborbital and orbital astronauts, to understand the science behind what spaceflight does to the human body.
Once my spacesuit was fitted, harness mastered, seat customized, and bio button in position, the team and I got to decorate postcards that would be flown in space. And if anyone here would like to have their own postcards flown in space, you have to check out Club for the Future's Postcards to Space program. After a long day, it was back to the astronaut village to rest up for our last day of training.
It is the end of day two here at the astronaut village. Before I got here, I was a little bit nervous. I still had some uncertainties about what would happen if there was an emergency. But now that we've gone through training, I can put those nerves aside and just focus on being really freaking amped to go. Like, now I'm really excited. I've cried like four times today. It's crazy to think that tomorrow's our last day of training and then the launch.
On our last day of training, we headed to the launch pad to see where we'd be taking off from the following day, and then headed over to see our rocket before it was rolled out to the launch pad. Finally, we ended our day with a few last mission scenarios back in our simulator.
This is our space capsule. Every passenger has their own window. I am in seat number 6. This is one of the emergency seats. It's like the emergency exit on an airplane. We are responsible for the fire suppression system. So if we were to see the fire indicator here, I would be responsible for pressing this button. And then we have our masks here in case for any reason we need to don a mask.
One of the coolest parts of this rocket is that it is reusable, which means Blue Origin brings back both the booster and the capsule, making it cheaper and less wasteful. Traditionally, rockets were thrown away after every launch, but with reusable rockets, you fly it, you land it, you make sure it's okay, and then you launch it again and again and again. Per Blue Origin tradition, we ended our training with a nominal or normal mission scenario. Got a quick pep talk from our incredible trainer, Sarah Knight, and then headed back to the astronaut village to rest up before the big day. I used this time to decompress in my Airstream and read letters that my parents, my brother, and my husband each wrote for me to read the night before my launch. The letter from my dad was especially meaningful. My dad grew up in poverty. He was the youngest of four siblings to a single mom. They didn't have a car or a home, and my dad worked since he was 11 years old to build a life for himself. He was the first person in his family to graduate from college, and so his college ring is one of his most prized possessions. And so, when I learned I was flying to space, I asked him a question.
So I just wanted to ask you if it would be okay if I brought your college ring, because I know that your college ring means a lot to you, if I could bring that to space with me when I fly.
Absolutely. An honor. That would be a thrill.
Before I could go to sleep, I had one last thing to do. I wanted to bring as many of you all on my flight as possible. And so I asked you to send me your dreams, and I put them all on this flash drive.
Okay, I'm putting all the wishes on the flash drive. 9,557 wishes. Look at these. Look how absolutely sweet and inspiring and just incredible.
And to make things even better, our Wishes to the Stars project raised over $30,000 for kids in foster care in West Virginia.
Now this guy is going in my flight suit, and I'm gonna launch your Wishes to the Stars tomorrow.
And then it was here, L minus zero, launch day. The morning of the launch, we get to say one final goodbye to our family and friends before getting suited up. For me, the most meaningful goodbyes were to my kids, Rose, who's 5, and Lincoln, who's 2. These goodbyes were a little harder because I wasn't just risking my life, I was risking their mommy's life, a risk I didn't take lightly. But I also wanted to show them that our dreams are worth fighting for. Dreams that do not simply go away once you become a mother, once you become a parent. Moms were all once little girls with big dreams, after all. And I knew that this little girl and so many others who follow my work were watching me today and hopefully thinking, one day, that will be me. We packed into the cars and drove past our family on the way to the launch pad. As we drove past our family and friends, I locked eyes with my daughter. I pointed at her and I said, I love you. I love you. My son is too young to remember this day, but I wanted my daughter to remember that the last thing mommy did before getting on that rocket was tell her she loves her. With that last goodbye, it was time to secure my dream.
I can't believe I'm here. I can't believe I'm here. This is the extra hydrogen burning off. We have liquid hydrogen and liquid oxygen fueling this rocket, but hydrogen is a very tiny molecule, so it leaks quite easily. And so to control those leaks in a safe way, they burn it off. Here we go. Let's go to space.
We have got to proceed. T-10, got to proceed. 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Ignition!
Shepherd has cleared the tower and is heading to space.
Guys, this is amazing. As I watched the Earth fall below me, I thought of all of my family and friends who helped get me here. And the words from my dad's letter were replaying in my head.
When you board the New Shepherd capsule, you won't just be carrying my ring into the stars. You'll also be carrying my dreams, my heart, and all my love with you. I love you, Dad.
Oh, wow, look at the dark. To the stars, as promised. I love you all. I hope all your dreams come true. That's our planet. Oh my God, that's space. We're in space right now. Oh my goodness. Oh my goodness.
1 minute warning.
Oh, this is beautiful. Our planet. Reach, reach, reach. In. Okay. Seek six and five and buckle. In about 20 seconds, the drogues are going to deploy. That's going to slow us down a little bit more. You can hear the thrusters thrusting. That's stabilizing our capsule as we descend back down to Earth. The capsule.
Stand by drogues.
Here come the drogues. Here we go. Whoa! Probes deployed. There we go. Amazing. Here we go. Yes! Woo-hoo! There go our drones! I'm the 100th woman in space! Flying to space was something I had dreamed about and worked toward for 2 decades, and it was everything I hoped it would be and so much more. I'm so grateful to my husband for being an equal partner in adventure, making it possible for both of us to have a family and a career. To my mom and dad, who became my inner voice telling me that all of this was possible. To my kids for always being the best part of my life. To everyone at Blue Origin who built this marvel of human spaceflight. And finally, to all of you. I hope you always
stay curious and
keep exploring!